Alright then, so today I would like to review my trip to Bolivia. Bolivia is an amazing country and absolutely unique. It is very different from all the other Latin American countries and has so much to offer. It's one of my favorite countries because it is so diverse in culture and it is the cheapest Latin American country out there. Well, at least in South America. Maybe Nicaragua, depending on the crisis, might be even cheaper. But it was very, very cheap and also very beautiful. So I went there from Peru. So I took the bus from Cusco, which is very close to the Machu Picchu, to La Paz.
It is the bus which takes us all the way from Cusco to La Paz.
They have many direct buses, but I chose the tourist bus, which is called IHOP, I think. They cost a bit more, but they are also more convenient. First of all, it's safer, very comfortable, because I was afraid that it could be very cold at night, since you have a high altitude, and some buses still use air condition, so you will have a bad time sleeping, and I have like a phobia of night buses. I hate night buses, because I had a few very bad night bus rides. The worst night bus ride, for example, was in Nepal, so never take a night bus in Nepal. And generally I'm very careful with those night buses because they make me crazy. You know, if you can't sleep, it's a bumpy ride, it's cold, the whole next day is gonna be boom. Anyway, it was a very comfortable ride with this company. It was $60, $59, and the good thing with this company is that it stops at certain places along the road. So, from Cusco, the first stop is at the Titicaca Lake.
Alright, so these are the floating islands.
But it's on the Peruvian side, actually. The Titicaca Lake borders to Peru as well as to Bolivia. Yeah, so actually the first stop was on the Peruvian side. You can see the floating villages, was really interesting. And then we crossed the border to Bolivia in the morning.
We just crossed the border. Here you can still see Peru, and there is the Titicaca Lake, which is on both sides.
But for certain nationalities, like the US, you have to pay a very expensive visa. Yeah? US citizens, Romanians, Indians, they pay, I don't know exactly how much it is, but I think it was at least $100. That was really expensive for them. But for Germans, most European countries, it's free. Yeah? So it was very easy, get your entrance stamp, and then we headed further to the Titicaca Lake on the Bolivian side. So, we stopped in the city called Copacabana.
It's a beautiful little town.
Don't get confused with Copacabana in Brazil, the beach. This is a city, this is a village. Yeah, this is a beach town. Not beach town, lake town, because the beach is not really nice. They don't have fine white sand. So, it is a very nice little town, but the highlight, in fact, is the Isla del Sol. So, and this IHOP bus company arranges tours for the tourists. Yeah, so that's why you stop like 3, even 4 hours in between. Yeah, so the whole way from Cusco to La Paz takes a bit longer, but you see many things on the road, on the way. Yeah, so you pay them $10 extra, first for the floating villages, another $10 for the Isla del Sol. And Isla del Sol was magnificent.
And then we bought the boat to the Isla del Sol, and seeing those landscapes with the snow-covered peaks, the very clear water, the little hills, the sunshine reflecting in the waves.
It is so beautiful in landscapes, like you take the boat, go to this island, the ride takes about 30-40 minutes, and on the way it's just you can see the snow-covered mountain peaks in the background on the crystal clear water, the islands, the trees. It is just an amazing landscape. It reminds me of Canada, New Zealand, one of the best places on earth. And I was just watching a documentary about Patagonia here in Chile, and it looked very similar. So I really like this Isla del Sol Titicaca Lake tour. On Isla del Sol, we had 2 hours to walk around, see the village, see the alpacas, yeah, the little the animals there, and yeah, the local people, they're also having those cholitas, yeah, which are here. You can see this is a doll, very similar to this place. He has a little alpaca, and they're having these colorful dresses. And I met also this little girl with her alpaca called Esmeralda.
So, this guy is called Albino, and your name?
Yeah, Esmeralda.
She was taking photos for a tourist for 30 cents, because for them it's good money. And it was really lovely. I really enjoyed the Isla del Sol. Then returning to Copacabana and heading to La Paz, arriving there in the evening.
So I have arrived in La Paz and I just checked in the hotel yesterday night. $15.
The whole bus ride took 24 hours from Cusco to La Paz, but it was worth because of the stops. The other tour companies are a bit cheaper and go straight there, but you will miss the Titicaca Lake. So that's why I recommend this IHOP bus company. Arriving in La Paz, first impression wasn't the best. It was a bit shady. Lots of poor people, run-down buildings, very old, not necessarily clean. So because I arrived late, usually I stay in Airbnbs like here, but because I arrived late, sometimes it's difficult to check in since you won't have mobile internet on arrival, since you can't always buy it at the border. So I decided to stay in a hotel the first night, since hotels have usually a 24-hour reception. And this hotel was in such a shady part of town. It was like the bus also arranged your taxi to go there, the IHOP. And there was a guy peeing on the street, lots of homeless people sleeping there, dirty. It was almost like, I don't know, it was really not so good impression. But it just got better afterwards. So I stayed in this hotel, which wasn't too good either, but it was cheap. Then I checked in my Airbnb. Beautiful view on the city.
So this is the view from a wonderful new apartment.
And also on the gondola system of La Paz. Be aware, La Paz is not the capital of Bolivia. Yeah, so there is like, I don't know if it's a conflict, but yeah, if you see on Google Maps, La Paz and Sucre are both the capitals.
You have this dot which shows the city as a capital, is La Paz and Sucre. You have this nowhere else in the world. So when you Google for capital of Bolivia, it shows you Bolivia have two capitals, is La Paz and Sucre.
Because this is nowhere else on earth that the government is seated in La Paz, but the High Court, for example, is in Sucre. And most people are asked that Sucre is the capital. Because otherwise, La Paz would be the highest capital in the world, but because most people say Sucre is the capital, that's why Quito in Ecuador is the highest capital on earth. La Paz. La Paz is one of it's a high altitude city. So I got a bit dizzy in the beginning. You get easily out of breath since the altitude is 3,500 meters. Really, really, you know, high. So the air is very thin. Yeah, be prepared to get dizzy. There is medicine for altitude sickness, but for me it wasn't too bad. I just got out of breath and a bit dizzy. That's all. I hadn't thrown up or anything, so it was fine. Yeah, and they have a gondola system. Like you have the metro system in London, you have a gondola system which stretches in the entire city. I think they have 10 lines or so, and you just take gondolas all over, and this is also an amazing way to just see the city from the air.
So the ticket for the gondola is only 40 cents, and they're really fast.
It never stuck during my time. Yeah, I was afraid a bit of getting stuck in the gondola since there's no way out, but nothing happened. It is very safe, very reliable, and very cheap. Yeah, 40 US cents for a ride. But usually you have to pay if you change the line, so you have to pay again. There is no transfer like in the metro. Yeah, but still, for this price it's fine. So I spent a lot of time in the gondola exploring the city, going even to the neighbor city of El Alto, which, like the name says, is even higher than La Paz. And in El Alto, the architecture is even more interesting. They're having crazy futuristic houses which glasses, they're having an Iron Man house, they're having, like, this architecture is unique for Bolivia and is nowhere else be seen on this planet. So it's great to explore El Alto with the gondola, and then there's also, yeah, many things to see in La Paz itself. The old town, the San Francisco church, you can take a tour for, I think it was $2, and with your own guide, show you around, tell you the history, of the old Spanish occupation, where you can see the city was separated into the Spanish part and the indigenous part.
What was the difference?
The difference is the Spanish city is very organized.
Yeah. Yeah.
Still, the indigenous city is the opposite.
Oh, okay, I see. So even on Google Maps, you can see that the streets of the Spanish part are more organized than of the indigenous part.
Where the Spanish part is more organized, you can still see it nowadays on Google Maps that the streets are more organized. Yeah, it's not so messy. Yeah, it's gonna be like in straight lines and not being messed up like where the indigenous lived. So that was very interesting to learn about the history, about the Civil War, where you can still see bullet holes in the church.
And these are actually bullet holes from the National Revolution.
Beautiful view on the city as well. And yeah, that's about it. La Paz is not a really big city. Yeah, I think they have, I don't know how many residents they have, a million or something. Or even less, I think they have less than a million. But together with El Alto, they have more than a million. So, it's not a really huge city, but there are many things you can do from there. For example, this thing here. This is the t-shirt, that's why I'm wearing it. The Death Road Tour. The Death Road Bike Tour. I wasn't firstly interested in it because it is also quite expensive, especially for Bolivian standards. It cost $53 for a day trip. Yeah? So you come back in the evening, go in the morning, and come back in the evening, and yeah, it's quite expensive. But my landlady from my Airbnb apartment said that it was really amazing. She loved it and highly recommend going there. So I thought, maybe I'll check it out. So I went to the downtown. After I went to this church, I asked at the tourist agency, yeah, can you book me on a tour tomorrow? And it's Death Road, isn't it dangerous? He said, no, don't worry. Yeah, the mosquitoes are the most dangerous thing. But in fact, it was much more dangerous than I expected, because you know, you ride with a bike along very steep cliffs and there's no safety line, so you just have to fall and you die. And this is what happened to some of the riders.
What happened?
Shit, there's a driver.
Huh?
There's somebody.
Oh, fuck.
It's our group.
So of one rider, this when I went there. So I was starting on top. It's really high altitude, over 4,000 meters, 4,600, I think. And it's basically all downhill. Yeah. So you just have to sit on the bike, very convenient. You can go. But it's also very cold due to the high altitude. So it was freezing on top. And then it even started to rain. And it was like, I got soaked wet in this cold. It was really uncomfortable. So I decided I'd go back to the car with a few other riders. And then we went on the car further, on the van. And then we had to stop because there was an ambulance. And we checked what was going on. And we saw the guy was lying there deep in... Yeah, deep down there. There was a shock for us. We waited until the ambulance came, until they could get down to check if he's still alive. And unfortunately, he was dead. So, tragic accident, which actually happened very often after I made research. God, at least one tourist dies a year in this road. And even if you don't fall down, there could be like there was an Israeli girl which got hit by a boulder, by a big rock, falling down. So it's really dangerous to ride this road. I would discourage people to go it, although it is a beautiful scenery and it can be fun, but the risk is really high. The whole road, I think it took 4 to 5 hours, and when you go down, like you're starting at 4,600 meters, going down to 1,600, and there it's warmer, it's very different climate, there's a river, and we had a buffet which wasn't so good. It was like a group of 20 people and then only one chicken, for all these people, and then rice and stuff. So the buffet was so-so, especially for this price, you would expect a bit more in Bolivia. So I think this tour is a little bit overcharged. Yeah, and it's risky. Yeah, and this guy, by the way, he was from New Zealand, as we discovered later. 2 days later, it was in the news. Of course, Bolivia never talked about it. Searching the news, what happened, they never said anything. Later, I found on other websites, from New Zealand website, oh, a New Zealand guy died in Bolivia. So, Yeah, it's really dangerous, and I really didn't like that they didn't warn you about the danger. Then, another thing to do in La Paz are the Cholita wrestling.
Welcome to the Cholita Luchadores. The line is long because it's a very popular event.
Yeah, event. So, twice a week, every Sunday and every Wednesday or Thursday, you can see the Cholita wrestling for what, $8 or $9, including a drink and a little souvenir. And yeah, this was really spectacular. This was really high. I would highly, highly recommend the Cholita wrestling, but I would not recommend the bike tour. So the Cholita wrestling, it's basically show, you know, lucha libre. Yeah, it's open fight, it's wrestling, it's all show, but it was very interesting, and it is fascinating how acrobatic those little chubby women are. They, you know, they were flying through the ring. Yeah, so I enjoyed the entire show. The Cholita show wrestling was my highlight because they also involved a lot of the audiences. So they often went out of the ring to continue the fight, and they were really acting furious. They took the drinks of the tourists and spilled the coke in the face of the you know, opponent. And it even took my beer. So when I was filming there, I said, oh, they take my beer and just pour it over this other Cholita's head. It wasn't cheap, the beer, $2, I think, or more. And yeah, that was really hilarious. Then there was supposed to be a title match, and the opponent didn't come. So the Cholita was getting the title, but then there was some kind of mole or werewolf Cholita hater who just came into the ring, stole the title, destroyed it, and then all the Cholitas came to fight with him. It was so hilarious. The referee was acting super gay, kissing people in the audience, kissing the male fighters, and it was an amazing show, highly worth the money, and so much better than this bike ride. You know, a lot of bike ride is cool too, I guess. When the weather would have been better, if nobody would have died, and they would just have better food, it probably might have been better. Also, there are like, I think, 3 or 4 companies. Maybe I didn't took the best company. My company was called No Fear. There was also a festival in La Paz, yeah? The Agresita Festival, I think it was the name. Yeah, so and this Alecita, yeah, the Alecita festival, yeah, it's a very superstitious festival. People buying miniature stuff for this echo dwarf because it's going to their belief that it brings them good luck, you know. So when they have a little house, a little car, a little money, and then they go to this witch who puts it under the burnt steam, and it becomes true. So people really get a house or a car in the future. That's what I believe. I don't know, I wouldn't do that, but this is like, yeah, I think believing some of the most superstitious people. Very interesting to see this kind of event. Streets were filled, then they had this amusement thing, and many interesting stuff, like lots of kicker tables.
This kicker field is so crazy long. Yeah. Like from here, going all the way back there.
And like, it's like an amusement village. Yeah, like this theme park, but all, everything, it's like the little stalls. Yeah, also with local food, fortune telling by a bird.
So the bird decides your future. Then I choose the right bird.
Very interesting to see. I enjoyed the day as well. Yeah. And after La Paz, I took the bus to Uyuni. Uyuni Salt Lake is also maybe even the biggest tourist attraction in the entire country because it is a lake which reflects the sky and everything. They call it Sky Lake, Mirror Lake.
So welcome to the Salt Flats. It's incredibly bright here because of the reflection of the sun.
Yeah, it's just beautiful. You go there, you must go there with a tour. Tours are not too expensive. I paid, I think, $16 more or less. but it was a Spanish-speaking tour, which is okay, I could practice, but I didn't understand much and it wasn't too talkative. So anyway, I enjoyed it. For English-speaking tours, you pay at least $30. So they might tell you a little bit more, but there is not too much history and things. It's just, as long as you see the lake, you should be fine. They also take you to like a train cemetery where all trains are.
So this is the train cemetery, very close to Uyuni. Basically, there are just a lot of train wrecks in the desert.
To another tourist village where they had like a salt museum, and then eventually they take you to the lake, and then you spend hours on the lake. It almost gets boring, even though it's beautiful, it's always the same, everything is reflected. They're going to take you to this monument, this Dakar Rally monument. They're gonna have some lunch there, and but it's very good for the price, I think. And it's very fascinating to see the reflection of the sky, later the sunset. Yeah, lots of tourists, and they all go with their four-wheel drives, take you to this lake. Yeah, and then from there, so I only spent 2 nights in Uyuni, so one trip, so I arrived in the evening, do a trip, and the next day I went to here, to Chile. There's a direct bus from Uyuni to Calama. Calama is a city in the north. I forgot the price of the bus, I think it was $25 or something. Very convenient also, go straight there, immigration was easy. Yeah, beautiful landscapes. Alright, that's about it, that's about Bolivia. Great country, highly recommend visiting there, and I hope I can go again to see the Amazon, to see Sucre. There's so much more to experience in this beautiful little country. I think I've even forgot something. There's so much to tell. Bolivia, highly recommend, even though they have no sea. They're having a little argument with Chile because in the war in the past they lost their connection to the sea, so now there is landlocked. For food, they eat llama steaks. I don't know if they have alpaca steaks, but llama steaks, it tastes all right. The other food was also good, and the good thing is, oh, it's so cheap.
There's even more food, it's unbelievable. I thought for $2, this would be enough, but no. This is the real lunch, and this is actually a rabbit. They call it falso conejo. So this is beef, actually. Yeah? Beef, but they call this rabbit. Falso conejo, let's see how this tastes. So this was very delicious and I'm almost full already. And they even have a banana for dessert and everything for just $2.50.
It's really cheap. For $2 you get a 3 meal menu, yeah? Like a salad, a big meal and a soup or a drink or something. And it's $2, $2.50. Very amazing, I love that. Yeah? So cheap countries you can always, you know, live better. Also my apartment was crazy cheap. Like here, this apartment, it cost $34. Yeah, in Bolivia, I paid, I think, $12 for a similar apartment. It was really nice. Yeah, like, yeah, that's why I like it. You can have a good life, because here I live almost over my limit. I don't earn that much. Yeah, so please subscribe. Yeah, so I can get more money for my travels, since right now in Chile, which is the second most expensive country in South America, I barely can survive with my earnings. So, thanks for watching and stay tuned! Peru is coming up next!